Make no mistake, it is a war out there, with our neighborhoods as battlefields, child soldiers shooting at each other with weapons of war, and all of the horrific results of war.
It's all hands on deck. It's all hands on deck. And if everybody's got a role to play in this.
The chair of the Public Safety and Governance Committee, Scotty Johnson, assembled at City Hall some of those on the front lines to give assessments from their vantage points, from clergy preaching the need for continuous care after shootings.
After I have preached their son's funeral, 6 months later, 2 years later, I got to preach their mom's funeral because she had a heart attack, because blood pressure was up too high, because she was having nightmares, she committed suicide.
To the need for proper funding of those who, until now, have been expected to go to battle with little to no compensation.
You have a problem when you want to invite and tell a member to come out, here, I'm going to need you to leave work today to come down here to volunteer at this event or to volunteer at this in particular place. That's the part that has to change. We're all human. We all got bills. We all got things we have to do.
Brothers Inc. told the committee without a central command that is coordinating efforts financially and strategically, community groups are battling each other for the same budget dollars.
There's no need to fight over funding. There's no need to fight over territory. There's no need to fight for none of that. Only thing we need to fight for is this gun violence. And we need to do that together.
Unfortunately for Cincinnati, we have been guilty of one thing, and that is starting things and stopping them.
Bishop Ennis Tate with the Peace Builders Network says City Hall has allowed politics to end programs that never got a chance to get a foothold and has not legitimized the battle against gun violence by creating a central location to fund it.
Foundations, investors, private funders, they began to get involved because the city is not only using its resource to plant the seed, but the city is using its influence to elevate the need.
And I'm told from a good source that the city is just weeks away from announcing a central office to coordinate the fight against gun violence, hopefully sometime shortly after the new year. Kyle?
All right, David, leading us off tonight. Thank you so much. We're going to turn now to those city gun ordinances designed to combat gun violence. Members of the Public Safety and Governance Committee passed on to the full council two pieces of legislation. We're going to break those down to you right now. The first requires people to report a gun lost or stolen. This is already a state law, but Keating wanted to codify it locally so it can be prosecuted by the city. She says the county prosecutor's office has bigger issues to deal with. The second would require people to pay a processing fee of $200 if they want their guns returned after they end up in police custody. This would only apply to people who are determined to have been irresponsible with their firearms.
I think in a year, when we look back at the data, I think it will start to move the needle a little bit. It is not the most significant things we can do because we are blocked by state law to be able to do that. I think the most significant thing would be to put a safe and require safes in cars for firearms because we have hundreds of guns stolen out of cars every year.
So Keating wanted to make it very clear here that $200 fee would not double victimize people who legitimately have their guns stolen, but is meant to encourage people to be more responsible gun owners. Opponents say that gun owners should not be subject to a patchwork of city gun ordinances. The full council is expected to vote on those ordinances coming up tomorrow.
Sure, you can stop watching, but let's be honest, you want to know more. Tap the links or even better, click subscribe to stay in the know.